Okay, welcome back everybody for learning the tools of the trade, right? Tools for selling your ideas. Now we just covered some time back the third party story, and remember that a third party story, right, which may be fictitious, but over a period of time it has to become a true party story that we discussed earlier. So this all becomes the actual references. So when you go to a school, right, to sell a course, same way, if you have any idea, you let's say yesterday we were talking about right, selling a plug point, right? Or it's like the extension box. The extension box can be sold in the railway stations. Same way, anywhere. It's like wherever you go, place. Initially, when they say that I don't want to buy it, you say that, okay, that person just bought it. So when somebody says that that person just bought it, it creates the confidence. Now, the next thing is a very interesting thing that we come across, and that's called as grabber. Grabber is anything that grabs your attention. So you see these posts on your social media channel. Every time you are scrolling down, suddenly there is something that grabs your attention. Yes. And then you stop. What is the, let's say when you're scrolling, right, or maybe when you're doing window shopping, okay, what is the most easiest thing that grabs your attention for shopping? What do you think? When you go to shopping, why do you even take a look? Anybody?
Something that attracts your eyes.
Like what? Let's say you're going to a shopping mall. All right. What makes you enter a shop? You don't go to shopping mall?
They display clothes.
Clothes, the display, you know? Same way, right? Have you heard of this thing called free? Have you heard? There is something called as free.
Yeah, offers.
Have you come across something called as, right, heavy discount, sale for today? Yeah.
Pricing.
Anything. So what happens is, for pricing or anything, it just grabs your attention, right? The dress, right? One beautiful dress, how much ever expensive it is, but it is beautiful and it is the highest of the quality, it grabs your attention. Correct? The same way, anything that is going to, when you're driving or when you're going on, right, using public transport, right, you see, come across something, right, a billboard, it grabs your attention. So any news that grabs your attention, anything, is called as a grabber. Now, it's something like this, right, 50% off. Tell me one thing, in this right screen, right, when you talk about 50% off or go mobile for free, right, what do you think you should be seeing in this?
Free.
You should be seeing free. And as a customer, Let's say mobile. If you're the customer, what would you see?
50% off.
50% off. That is very clear and prominent. But always remember that these are all grabber.
Conditions apply.
Conditions apply. Yeah. Perfect. So what happens is, these are all grabber. It is supposed to grab your attention. So a grabber is truth, but not the whole truth. So I repeat, a grabber is truth, but not the whole truth. I'll give you 50% off, right? But when I see this star here, and when you see this small font, it says conditions apply. So I will give 50% off if you buy another product. So when you buy the first product, I will give 50% off on the second product. You got it? So I'm paying 100% for the first product, 50% for the second product. So totally how much I'm paying? 150. Correct? For two products. So that means for one product, I'm paying 75. So it's actually not a 50% sale. It's actually a 25% sale. You got it? For buying one product for 100, right? I'm buying two products for 75 each. So it's actually a 25% sale. But what caught my attention is I'm getting 50% off the second product. So when I'm going to talk about it, what did you buy? I bought this in a great sale. They are providing 50% off. Are they going to do this math and calculate and tell others?
No.
So that's what the work of the grabber is. It is to grab attention. So why it needs to grab attention? One is to create interest. It creates curiosity. And because of the sale or any kind of, let's say, it increases the excitement. And more so ever, right, it's used to increase the sale. Now, like we saw, 50% off. When we say 50% off, right, I'm giving 50% off on the second product. So I'm not only selling one product, I'm selling two products. So it increases the sale. So I repeat, a grabber is used to create interest, to create curiosity, to create excitement, and to increase sale. And as I told you earlier, a grabber is truth, but not the whole truth. You got it? Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
So as a homework for third party story and grabber, what I want is you guys have to practice writing down third party story for everything that you see or everything that you, for example, if you're visiting our website and working on our website, work and see everything that can become a grabber, work everything that can become a third party story, right? Every reference is a third party story. Every sale or every offer is a grabber, you know? So a grabber can be, right, something like free course, for example, the data science, right? A grabber can be for data science is, right, after the course, we are giving them the placement. It is truth that like we are going to give them the placement, but it's not the whole truth. We are going to give placement only to those people, right, who are going to complete the course. You understood? So for that, like you have to put the efforts to complete the course. You have to put the time to complete the course. You have to learn, and then we are going to. So the grabber can be that the fruit that is, or the result that is going to come at the end. But then all the efforts makes it as the half truth. Got it? Yes, no, not applicable.
Yes, sir.
Sir, please give an example.
Example? Okay. Example for, right, what do you want to sell? Let me, accordingly, I'll give you the example. You want it for the course or you want it for something else?
I wanted the course.
Course, okay. So let's say you want to sell which course? Just give me one course, whatever you want to sell.
Mathematics.
Mathematics, okay. So let's say you want to sell the mathematics course. Okay, for them, one of the grabber can be that for today, right, we are offering, right, the course, the entire year's 10 standard mathematics course, right, which was for 9999, that is almost 10,000 rupees, for 5999. So there is a 4,000 rupees discount on the mathematics course for the full year. So the heavy discount which is there for mathematics can be a grabber. You understood?
Yes, sir.
So anything like the offer for today, right? If you join today, again, this 999 is again, it's to make a feel-good factor. It's again a grabber, a kind of grabber, right? So if I say 1,000, right, it says, oh, it's 1,000. So suddenly people start seeing it's a big figure, right? But when it ends with 99, it's like it does not feel, right? When you say, how much is the cost? It says it's something 900. You're getting the point. So there is a difference between 900 and 1,000. How much is the difference between 900 and 1,000?
100 rupees.
100? Correct.
Yes.
The feeling is of 100 rupees. But the difference between 999 and 1,000 is only 1 rupee. You understood? That's the reason the pricing is, right? Most of the time, it ends with the 0.99 factor. You got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Same way, so you can write, for example, like the data science course that we are offering, right? It has got so many grabbers, right? Which can be used. These are all true. Like, for example, like a 55,000 rupee course that has been offered for 30,000, right? So heavy discount. Same way, I mean, the discount is offered for a certain time, right? But then duration that can be. After the completion of the course, they have the placement. The placement can be a grabber. After, right, what they have, once they finish the course, there is like one-on-one mentorship that is there with the course, which again is a cost-effective addition, right? It does not come so easily because so you have career counseling, you have all this, right, is going to cost money. You know, if you go into the market, but then anything that is going to cost money and we are giving something, right, without the cost, it's going to be. So as an example, so if let's say today, if let's say one of the mobile company offers, like we saw, it's like it's offering free mobile, right? When you say free, when you get inside the shop, this grabber is to get them inside the shop. Okay, it has got nothing else to do. So once he gets the, right, let them find out what it is. So for example, when you say that this is, the mobile is for free, okay? But when you get inside the door, they say that the mobile is for free, but you will have to sign a 1-year contract with us for using our services. Understood? Yes. Yeah. So it is. So as I told you, grabber is truth, but not the whole truth. The next thing that Dex tool of the trade that we are going to learn is one of the most effective way of selling. Right, most effective way of selling. Now this even, right, let's say a banana vendor. Have you ever bought bananas on the street?
Yes.
Or a fruit or a vegetable, yes. Anything, a fruit vendor, right? You go on the street, they use these things all the time, the next tool of the trade, but it's the most effective one. How it is this? It's called as the takeaway. Now, takeaway is used to create need, one, create desire, create exclusivity. It releases the pressure of buying, and it also creates the fear of loss. That means if I don't buy this thing now, I'll never be able to get that. That kind of fear. You know? So we were talking about a banana vendor or a fruit vendor. Okay. So let's go to this scene of the market. Now, he is not using it consciously. He does not know that is takeaway, correct? He's using it out of his experience. Always remember that. So what is happening is, let's say I want to sell right banana. And right when, let's say your mommy goes to buy that banana and your mommy uses it. Takeaway all the time, right? How, what it is, let me explain you. What I'm going to do is this, let's say mommy has created or cooked biryani for the day. You guys like biryani? Yes, no?
Yes.
Yes? Right, any delicacy or any food that she has created. Now you are right hungry. Okay. For let's say last 2 days, you've not had proper food and like, right. And now, right, you're hungry and you just go, right, directly to the dining table and you want to eat, right? And mommy, right, pulls off the plate. Right? And says that first go and wash your hands. what would you do?
Go to and wash your hands.
Go and wash your hands. Right? What mommy has done? Mommy has died. Mommy has taken away the thing that you wanted the most and made you do certain things that she wants you to do. Now, mommy says, right, you can have this, but you will have to do 10 sit-ups. What would you do?
Do the sit-ups.
Correct.
Bargain for five.
So everything that mommy is going to say, because you are hungry for 2 days, you have not eaten properly, right? For 2 days. And biryani is your favorite food. And mommy has made it.
And second thing, mommy ka sunna hi padega.
Haan, but like, kahin pe bhi jao, yehi hone wala hai. Agar aapko, aapka favorite food hai, and if you are told to do certain things, you will do it. Right? So, now what happens? Now coming back to the fruit vendor. Okay. Have you ever seen mommy going and bargaining? Mommy goes and says that, okay. He says that mommy, when he says, mom, when she goes and says, bhaiya kitne ka diya? Right? Right? So he says, sab jo hai, right, 100 rupiah dozen. So sab jo hai, 100 rupiah kilo. Or, kela jo hai, right, he says, 50 rupiah dozen. Right? What is mommy going to say? Oh, ye lo 50 rupiah, ye lo 100 rupiah de do. Is she going to do that?
No.
Right? What is mommy going to say?
Bargain.
She is bargaining. So mommy is going to, right, use her weapon called as takeaway. What she is going to do? She is going to say, kya bhaiya ye jo hai, right, 100 rupiah. वो तो आपका बाजू वाला वो जो है वो 80 रुपए किलो में दे रहा है. करेक्ट?
यस सर.
हाँ. सो व्हाट इज द सेलर गोइंग टू डू? व्हाट इज द सेलर फ्रूट सेलर गोइंग टू डू?
सेम ओनली.
हाँ.
केम 90 रुपीस.
He will say, बहन जी आप हमेशा मेरे से लेते हो, ठीक है आपके लिए मैं 90 रुपए करके दे देता हूं. So then, right, in the bargain, so mommy has given a takeaway and the vendor is going to reduce the price and give it. Right? So mommy is happy, vendor is happy. Now let's say the vendor is shrewd and he knows, right, to do the takeaway. Okay, now vendor is going to you. Mummy says that wo baju wala jo hai 80 rupaye ka de de, right, and the vendor says theek hai mummy ji aap wahin se jaake le lo uska kela 80 rupaye wala ke 80 rupaye wala jo sab hai wo bahut acha hai usse hi jaake le lo aap. मेरा 100 रुपया थोड़ा महंगा है लेकिन राइट उसका अच्छा है जाओ ले लो उधर से. व्हाट इज मम्मी गोइंग टू डू?
हंड्रेड रुपीज में ही ले लेंगे.
यू गॉट इट? सो एज इट इज द मोस्ट टेक अवे इज द मोस्ट इफेक्टिव टूल, it is also the most dangerous tool. If you don't use it effectively to make it an effective tool, it can become a dangerous tool. How it can become a dangerous tool, let me tell you. Right? There are two options that mommy could have done. One, she could have always walked out of this guy, right, and bought it from the other guy. Because he felt, she felt that, okay, he's not treating her properly. You know, so that it can, you can lose a customer also on that. But then if you are using it effectively, correctly, then this is always going to be working. Now, when you talk about takeaway, the key word is no. So understand that. This product is not meant for everybody. I'm giving you, right? Right, I'm giving you an example. Okay, let's say this, when you're talking about course, or when you're talking about any product, I say that this product is not meant for everybody. It is meant only for a few exclusive people, right, who want to have an exclusive lifestyle. So if you're talking, selling a lifestyle product, it's going to be this statement. If you're going to, right, sell apples, right, you say that this apple is not meant for everybody. It is meant only for a few exclusive people who look for organic and quality for their stomach. So what do you feel? What would you do? Would you go for it or no? When I say that this product is not for you, one, you can go under depression and say, oh yeah, this product is not meant for me. Or two, how can you say that this product is not meant for me? I will buy it and prove it to you that this product is meant for me. You understood? So the no is the key word. So, jaane do na, mem saab. He just says, jaane do, udhar jaake le lo aap. So when he says that, you're going to buy. You know, he's saying, no, I'm not selling. Always remember that if a salesperson is using takeaway, right? The product is exclusive, or he knows how to make the product exclusive. So this statement that this product is not meant for everybody, you're very clear, like you're going to shake your head and say that this product is not meant for everybody. It is meant for few exclusive people, right, who want to, right, have a real good product, who want to have quality, who want to have something which is like only with exclusive people, right? It's not a common thing. Understood? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
So a takeaway is the most effective tool and the most dangerous tool. Understood? Now, the second part is very important. A takeaway can be always counter-attacked. So, mommy did the takeaway saying that, okay, your neighbor is giving it for 80 rupees. Right? So, it was counter-attacked by the vendor. He said, 80 rupees, go and take it. It's a very good quality. Very good quality, madam, that one. This, no, it's expensive. You take it from there only. Right? Bahut achha sehat ho jayega usse. So what happens? Mummy is going to buy it from here because it has been counter-attacked. Okay. And the most important thing when it comes to takeaway is a takeaway always works when it follows grabber. So the grabber is, let's say, it's a very exclusive quality of product, right? Now, when you're saying that, automatically, right, let's say this is organic. The food is organic. You're selling that. It's become exclusive. Like now, if somebody wants to have healthy lifestyle, right? Organic is healthy lifestyle. So there is always a grabber on that. Now, if I say that, madam, wohi le lo, usme bahut pesticides hai, bahut acha taste bhi hai. What is she going to do? She is going to buy the organic and healthy one because everybody wants healthy one. So the grabber, healthy thing is the grabber. And when it follows, right? I mean, it is takeaway follows grabber, right? It works. Because there is this grabber, takeaway will always work. Clear on this? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
So let's go in the sequence of all the tool of the trade we have learned so far. We did trial close. Now, for trial close, what we have done, right? We understood what they wanted. We inquired, we spoke to them, we questioned them, we understood what all the information, we gathered all the information with the trial close. With the fact benefit selling, we opened the door and, right, removed the defense of the person, right? Then we did the third party story to increase the credibility and the confidence in buying the product, right? And there we also used grabber to get them into the store or get them to buy the product. And then we have created, with all this, we have created that this product is very exclusive. And because this is exclusive, this is not meant for everybody. It is only meant for few exclusive people. For example, let's say I'm going to apply for a job, right? And I'm saying, oh, yeah, I'm available whatever time you say, whenever time you say, I'm ready to join, I'm ready to do this, everything that you say I'm going to do. Will I get this job?
No.
Because there is no exclusivity. Right? But if I say that, no, this I cannot do. This is right for the, if you want to do this, you will have to do this for me. If I want you, I can do this, cover this up very clearly. It will take time, but then if you want this to be the result, I want this to be the returns for me. So what happens is I'm negotiating and I'm giving them the exclusivity. If I'm the only person who knows this particular way of doing things, so I'm creating exclusive. I know I'm like, so for example, if I'm learning data science, right? I know that I'm among the few people who have learned data science and there is a demand in the market. So I would not undersell myself. Same way, if I'm going to be the salesperson and if I know that I can generate, right, 1 crore rupees, right? I can always tell, right, the person who is taking this, I will generate 1 crore rupees, but if you want that, right, I want this package. I want 10,000 rupees for every sale I make. Right. So I want every, right, 1 million rupees, that is 10 lakh rupees sale, I want 10,000 rupees. every, let's say 5 lakh rupees sale, I want 10,000 rupees. So what happens? If it is right reasonable, what is the other person going to do? What is the HR person going to do? Hire you or no? Anybody home? They will hire you or not? Hello? Where are all of you guys? Huh? Rahul, tell. They will hire? Yes, no? Oh, you're typing. Okay. Right, so takeaway is, right, as we understood, it always works when it follows grabber. So use takeaway carefully, right? And use it exclusively. Create exclusivity before using the takeaways. The next is called as urgency. So urgency is used to create fear of loss, to create aggression in the presentation. You want to finish things up fast, fast, fast. And it helps the person to create a decision faster. Right, decide fast in simple terms, right? It also helps to increase the working standards because like you are effectively working fast, and same way it will increase the efficiency part of it. Okay, now urgency is how it is going to work. Urgency. My quota is getting over. This is, we have very limited seats available. We have only limited product available. We have only this much product available. We don't have anything more than this. It will be given only to 10 people out of 10,000 people. Right? First,
last 2 days.
Last 2 days. Right? So all this is for urgency part. Okay. So what we have covered so far is, right, I repeat, trial close, then you have fact benefit selling, then you have third party story, then you have grabber, then you have takeaway, and sixth, we have urgency. So 6 tool of the trade, all the 6 tool of the trade, if you are able to use it, right, 20% of your sale is guaranteed. That means 20% of your chances of you selling the product is a guarantee. Let's take a break and let's understand for doing all this, right? If it is going to be only 20% effective, what is it that makes and breaks the sale? It is the most important tool of the trade. And it is so important, the next tool of the trade is that 80% of the sale depends on that. Everything else under the sun, right, is just 20% of the sale. So after the break, we will continue and understand what is the next tool of the trade and what is the most important tool of the trade. Any questions so far? Anybody? You can always put it on the chat. Okay, so thank you for joining this session. Yeah, Rahul, what is your question? Okay.
No questions, sir.
No questions? Okay, you did some annotation, that's the reason. Anyway, so thank you for this particular part. And we will continue after the break, right, to understand the most important tool of the trade.